3 times 2 is?
6.
Minus 1.
5.
Who said that?
Erica,
yes.
Look up here, please.
Yes.
Let's test this one. Let's test this one right here. We put in 4. 3 times 4. 5 1. Let's test this one. You have to quiet for a minute. 8 times 3. 8 times 3 times 8. 8.1.
23.
That work? Is that the whole? Good job.
I think you know,
who said no, you did? What is it?
Y equals 2x plus 2.
Let's see if he's right. Let's pick one. 2 times 2 equals 4 plus 2 is 6. He's right on that one. Let's see if he's right on this one. 2 times 5 equals 10 plus 2 equals
12.
Yay! So if you're right, and there is indeed a steady rate, you tested all of these. If you put in any x to the current equation, you should be able to get y. If you put in any y, you should be able to get x. So if I put in my y, let's see, n equals, I'm waiting for odds. Guys, it just gets really old. It's not a hard direction. I'm not asking you to do something impossible. I'm asking when we're doing something on the board that you're looking up at the board. That's all. I'm going to put in y. My y is 10. I'm looking at this line of my in-out y. So 10 equals 2x plus 2. Here's where we're going to. How would I solve this for x? I've got to clear out my x side. Opposite of add is subtract. I'm going to take away 2. Now I've got 8 equals 2x. I took away 2 from both sides, kept it balanced, did the same thing to both sides. This is 2 times x, I'm going to divide by 2. 2 divided by 2 is 1. Divide by 2, 4 equals x. So if y equals 10, x should equal 4. It does. Again, if I put in this one, 6, for one, here's my y, 14. Take a look up here, and you're going to be less confused. I'm using this equation.